Hello friends, welcome to my channel once again, and I hope everyone is fine in this scenario of COVID-19. Friends, as I told you before that we are going to begin the classes, regular classes in on YouTube regarding the syllabus. Okay, and one by one topic I am going to clear. Okay, so we have begun with the drama, unit one. So one session we conducted last week, and the second session is regarding the drama writing in Elizabethan age, and we are going to share some of the very very important facts of drama today, and these facts are related to the first English tragedy and comedy in English. So let me share with you some of the important facts with the presentation. And I'm going to explain some of the important facts, and we will notice there that these facts are very very important or significant for the exam purpose of UGC NET. Okay, so let's begin with the presentation, friends. So friends, here you can see unit one, drama in Elizabethan age, and this is the part one of this video series of drama writing in Elizabethan age. So first we are going to learn something about the first comedy and tragedy in English literature. So let's begin, and after that we are going to learn about the pre-Shakespearean drama. For example, a university wits and Shakespearean drama, and expected questions from these drama writings of different playwrights or dramatists. Okay, so this unit one of drama of Elizabethan age will be very long, because many facts are there, because the development of drama was done it is done in this particular age, Elizabethan age. That's why it covers very very important facts and truths which can be very very helpful in the exam of UGC NET. So friends, let's move on. First of all, first comedy in English literature, when we talk about it, we have the name Ralph Royster Doister, written around 1553 by Nicholas Udall. So this one is very famous writing by Nicholas Udall, and it was written around 1553. So and it is the first comedy in English language, in English literature, and modeled on Terence and Plautus. Terence and Plautus are these are the classic playwrights in the history, and their works are like that. This comedy, the first comedy of English literature, was modeled on these classic playwrights' works. Then the protagonist in it is a doltish young man named Ralph. So Ralph is the name of that protagonist, and he is a doltish young man. He is the hero of this particular play, and it is a comedy, so some comic adventures are done by Ralph here. Ralph brags about his bravery, but he is a coward. So here we can see that Ralph is just telling everyone that he is very brave and he can do anything, but when real action comes, he cannot do anything. Okay, he is a coward. So he talks about his bravery, but in real sense he is a coward person. Then major characters are Ralph, Mary Greek and Constance. So these three are very major characters in this particular comedy. First is Ralph, then Mary Greek and Constance. And here we can see that in this particular play, Mary Greek urges Ralph to win the heart of the lady Constance, but he fails throughout the play and creates comic scenes. So the adventures, the scenes created in the play are so much comic that it became the first English comedy in the literature, and the adventures of Ralph became very popular because of this particular play. Then first tragedy in English literature. When we talk about the first tragedy, we have the name Gorboduc. Gorboduc is the first tragedy, considered the first tragic play, we can say, in English literature. And it has another title also, the tragedy of Ferrex and Porrex. Ferrex and Porrex, these are the two sons and two characters in this particular play. And it is the first blank verse tragedy in English language. Yes, first blank verse tragedy. Then it was written by Thomas Norton and Thomas Sackville. Friends, this particular tragic work is written by Thomas Norton and Thomas Sackville. Two writers are there for this particular play, and they have written different acts of this particular play. First performed in 1561 before Elizabeth I. So when Elizabeth I was reigning, she was ruling the Britain. So at that time, this particular play was first performed in front of her in 1561. Then it was published in 1565 with printing errors and published again in 1570 as the tragedy of Porrex and Ferrex. So when it was published in 1565, it has some printing errors in it, in the writing, in the narration. But after 5 years, it was republished and with a new name, The Tragedy of Porrex and Ferrex. Then, friends, some more facts about this. Gorboduc is the mythical king of Britain. The Gorboduc, the character here, is considered as the mythical king of Britain. And Norton wrote the first three acts and Sackville wrote the last two acts here, friends. As we talked earlier that some of the acts were written by Norton and others were written by Sackville. So, five total acts are there in this particular tragedy. And three acts are written by Norton, the first three acts, 1, 2, and 3. And the fourth and fifth, these two acts were written by Sackville. And when we talk about the story is taken from Geoffrey of Monmouth, Geoffrey of Monmouth's history of the Greek kings of Britain, in which the dispute between King Gorboduc's two sons, Ferrex and Porrex, is narrated. So the story, the base of the story is Geoffrey of Monmouth's history of the kings of Britain. So this is the base, friends. Geoffrey of Monmouth's history of the kings of Britain. And from this particular story of Geoffrey of Monmouth, the story of this particular work, Gorboduc, is taken. And in this story, there is a dispute between King Gorboduc's two sons, and the two sons are Ferrex and Porrex. And this dispute was so much serious that the Porrex one son killed the another son. Okay, Porrex, the younger brother, kills Ferrex and Videna. Videna is Gorboduc's queen, Gorboduc's wife, and the mother of all these sons. So Videna, Gorboduc's wife and queen, kills Porrex, her own son, as a revenge for Ferrex, because Ferrex was beloved to Videna. So basically, the tragic end is there in this particular play. So friends, these are the very important facts. I narrated some of the important facts here for the purpose of exam only. Because the plays are very long to discuss here, and only the important facts we need for the exam purpose. So the facts are here, and next video will be on Shakespearean comedies. Around 38 plays were written by Shakespeare, and from those plays, many plays are comedies, many are tragedies, and many are historical works. So first of all, we are going to learn about the comedies written by Shakespeare, only IMP facts for UGC NET exam purpose. Friends, so keep on watching my videos and subscribe to it to get free video lectures of different topics of UGC NET. And these topics are also very much useful for other exams which has English literature in its syllabus. So for TGT and PGT, you can also watch my videos because many important facts are there. Okay, till then, we are ending this session, friends, and see you next time. Thank you so much.